Hi, this is Kalyan Karmakar here and welcome to Finely Chopped Kitchens. Finely Chopped Kitchens is where I speak to you about the food cooked across the country. And it's a special day, it's the day of the harvest festival, the spring harvest across the country, winter turns to spring, as it said. And in that spirit, I thought that I'm going to bring to you as many sort of stories of harvest as I can. And I'm going to start with you one from the west of India, which is Gujarat. Now, in a recent story on the Pathare Prabhu community, I told you about a dish called the ghara, which they have during Sankranti, which is the harvest festival. And it's a Maharashtrian community. And the analogy I gave there was that too of the Undhiyu, which is a Gujarati winter speciality. And it's also had at Sankranti. So Sankranti marks the end of winter and the beginning of spring. And slowly all these winter delights go away. But before they go away, I've caught them for you. And here it is. So this is the Undhiyu. This has been sent by a lady called Ami Vyas. And Ami Vyas is a home chef who's based in Mumbai. And her page is called Tasty Licious. So she does a Surti Undhiyu, which is probably the most famous name which I've heard for the Undhiyu, because I'm sure the Undhiyu is made across different parts of Gujarat, whether it's Ahmedabad, Surat or whatnot. But each part, has each house, has their own taste. This has a lovely flavor. So a lot of winter vegetables which come into this. In fact, Ami was saying that she made 8 kilos, and it's a slow cooked dish. So it took her about 4 hours from preparation to finish. And the main spicing into it is a green chutney, which is coriander, finely chopped coriander, chilies, green garlic, which is a winter speciality. And all of this goes into this. And it's made in peanut oil, often lots of oil. And there's vegetables like purple yam, there is raw banana, there is brinjal, baigan. Then there is the papri, the surti papri, which is without which any surti undhiyu is incomplete. And this is the mutia. It's like a little dumpling which people look forward to the most. You can have the undhiyu with puri, with roti, hummus and parathas, and a bit of achar. And also in this part of the country, til, as it is in the north with lodi, is associated with Sankranti, and they make these til larus. So there you go. I'm Bengali, as you know, so undhiyu is a dish which I first had in the early 2000s when I was attending an Art Club of Mumbai workshop at the World Trade Center, and the buffet had undhiyu and I just loved it. And since then I've had many undhiyus, each of them is different, and in most cases I like them. So some of the ones which I've had, and oh god, you've got little Nimki, my cat, who's coming in, and he's you know, he's going to sniff at everything. Okay, listen, Nimki, what I've told you, that we eat from our own plates. So this is how it is eating with Nimki these days. So I've been trying to tell him that we eat from our own plates, and luckily this is not fish or meat, or he would have jumped on it. Which are the other lovely undhiyu eating experiences I've had? I've had it at the home of Anak Desai, and it was cooked by his mom, who's now no more, and his wife. She had made it, so she still makes it. And then once Anak Desai had sent it home as well, and he does these undhiyu parties, and Gujaratis in winter, they do undhiyu parties and they do ponk parties. And ponk is something which the Maharashtrians call hurda. It's a kernel of millets. And then there is the undhiyu from Som, a Gujarati restaurant here, which we have every undhiyu season. There was a shop called Regal Stores at Bandra, so sometimes we get undhiyu from there. So there are so you'll get undhiyu in the thali joints in Mumbai during winter. You have to check if there's undhiyu on that particular day. You will also get undhiyu sold at a lot of local stores, like I spoke to you about Regal, which is slightly posher, but there are also places like Hiralal Sweets and so on, which I've been reading, especially in areas in South Mumbai or Ville Parle. And you've got housewives doing their version of the undhiyu there. And like I said, it's to sum up, undhiyu is a winter dish, typical to the Gujarati community. And they, each part of the state makes their own one. This is the Surti undhiyu. And there's some winter specialities like the green garlic and the papri and the purple yam and everything which goes into it. You can pick, join it with a bit of pickle, paratha, puri, roti. You can have it with tilgur. I am Bengali, I'm not Gujarati. I'm someone who loves a lot of non-veg, but I enjoy the undhiyu because it reminds me of the medley of vegetables which the Bengali chaturi has, but different flavors. Like for example, the garlic is more prominent here. So like I said, it's a winter dish, but it's also had on Sankrant, which is a transition from winter to spring, and then it sort of ends. I had earlier told you on finally Food of Kisi Kitchens about ghara, the Pathare Prabhu version of it, and that had prawns. And I'm hopefully going to talk to you today also about Pongal, the Tamilian sort of Sankrant festival. And I'm also going to speak to you a bit from the east about post Sankranti and maybe a bit of Bihu. And let's see if I can also get you some Maharashtrian sort of Sankrant rituals as well. So it's a completely unplanned harvest festival on Finely Chopped TV, but fingers crossed. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this. I'm going to relish my Undhiyu and paratha, and thank you so much. This has come from Amy Vyas, home chef in Mumbai. You can check out her page, Tastylicious. That's little Nimki, my bat.